Hi, I'm Sebastian Marte, and in this video I'm going to give you an introduction to MagicQuartz. MagicQuartz is a turntable speedbox, which means you can connect your turntable to MagicQuartz and control its playback speed. What really sets MagicQuartz apart from other turntable speedboxes is that it has an optical feedback mechanism that allows MagicQuartz to measure the actual playback speed, and MagicQuartz is capable of calibrating the playback speed. So this means you can precisely set the speed that you want to have your records played back with. Let's have a quick look at the user interface. On the right hand side you can see four buttons that are used to control the firmware, which displays all the values and results on a backlit LCD screen. In the upper right corner there's a voltmeter that displays the currently generated voltage that is fed into your turntable. This voltmeter is actually optional, but I do highly recommend to include one of these into your MagicQuartz because it really simplifies adjusting the turntable motor. Now let's have a quick look at the main functions. This is the main menu, which allows you to control the playback speed. Unfortunately, you cannot hear any music because I had to turn down the volume because of the copyright protection, but you will get the idea. You can use a cursor to select the function or digit that you want to change. For example, here it's below the second three of the RPM setting. And then you can use the up and down buttons to increase or decrease the playback speed. You can also switch between the default record playback speeds. For example, now if this is 33, you can use the up and down buttons when you select RPM and switch, for example, to 16, 45 or 78 RPM. As you can see, whenever you change the upper value, it will automatically calculate the generated frequency, which is in this case set to 50 Hertz because this is a 50 Hertz turntable that was designed to operate here in Europe. Of course, you can also change the frequency, and it will automatically calculate the RPM that corresponds to this frequency setting. Let's go back to 33 RPM. With the T function you can transpose the playback music. For example, you can transpose it in half tones, up and down, and MagicQuartz will automatically do the math. On the lower right part you can see a flash symbol that indicates whether the turntable motor is running or not. For example, if I switch it off, you can see the flash symbol disappear. When you decrease the generated frequency, you will notice that MagicQuartz also decreases the generated voltage. This is necessary to be compliant with the motor characteristics, and this is also something that is done by MagicQuartz automatically. Another important setting is located in the upper left corner. This 33 tells MagicQuartz that the turntable is currently set to 33 RPM. If we switch MagicQuartz to 45 RPM, we would also have to change this value to 45. This then allows you to do the same calculations again, but for the 45 RPM setting. For example, we can go down to 33 RPM, and this changes the frequency to about 33 Hertz and makes the record player play back at 33 RPM, although it is set to 45 RPM. Now let's come to the most interesting part of MagicQuartz, the live quartz mode, where MagicQuartz automatically controls the playback speed. To enter live quartz mode, you have to select the Q symbol in the lower line. It will do a very quick automatic calibration of the optical sensor to make sure it's properly set up and then enter live quartz mode. Here you can see the current speed that is currently measured by MagicQuartz and the generated output frequency that is fed into your turntable and actually controls the playback speed. On the lower left part you can see the rotation indicator that is used to again make sure that the optical sensor is properly set up. This rectangle basically progresses to the next one for each rotation of the platter. The upper symbol displays a buffer status where the buffer is used to calculate the RPM that is displayed here on the top line. I'm not going into detail here because you can find this well explained in the online manual that you can find on my website. And on the right part you can see a small symbol that indicates the current quartz strategy. If it's displaying a playback symbol, you can be sure that MagicQuartz is operating very well and it's really keeping track of the playback speed. As you can see, there's only a very small difference between the current playback speed and the set playback speed. But if I change the pitch of the playback on the turntable, only a tiny amount, you can see that it's now down regulating the speed because I have increased the pitch, and now it's back on play symbol again. So if we, for example, also introduce some errors by really slowing down the platter, you can see that MagicQuartz now shows a cross, which means that it has been rejecting the measurements because they were the difference between the measurements was bigger than expected. So this is live quartz mode. I'm going to leave this again and go to the next function. The calibration function helps you to properly position the optical sensor. Let's do this. Now, the upper line gives you a graphical readout of the contrast range that is measured by the optical sensor, and it shows a check mark on the right, which means that the contrast is considered to be okay. If I, for instance, pull it back, you can see that it's now telling you to move it closer to the platter with this symbol. And the contrast is of course too low. Now it's okay again. This is the rotation indicator that I have talked about in live quartz mode. And this delta value is the difference between two measurements. Since there's currently no quartz regulation, this delta value should actually be zero. This is an indication how well the measurement actually works. As you can see here, it's showing a cross because the delta value is too high. Everything above 20 here is considered to be not okay. So what we have to do is to play around with the position of the sensor and see if it gets any better. This takes some time because the contrast has also changed. Now we're back to 20, 16. As you can see, a properly set up sensor really increases the performance of MagicQuartz, and the software really helps you to achieve this. Let's leave this function again and proceed to the setup menu. There you have several functions to set up MagicQuartz and fine-tune its performance. For example, it has also some information functions where it helps you to control the motor. For example, this function here displays the current draw of the motor. For example, if you switch it on and off, it tells you how much current it's now drawing. The sensor info accordingly displays the readout of the optical sensor. It also displays the uptime or the time a record has been playing. This is something that is very useful to keep track of stylus wear. It also tells you information about the wear leveling. Wear leveling means that MagicQuartz automatically spreads memory writes across the memory area to make sure that the lifespan of the internal flash memory is as long as possible. Since it has been first operated, it has done 12 memory shifts and the next one will be due in 6 hours. The calibrate motor function is something that you have to go through whenever you connect a different turntable to MagicQuartz. And this is basically used to set up the generated voltage and to control all the security features. It does some calibrations to measure current thresholds that are used, for example, for the overload protection. And this calibrate function does this all automatically, although you can enter these values manually. I will come back to this later. But now let's go quickly through calibrate motor. So it tells you to turn the motor off and then press the OK button. Now it has detected the amplifier current on idle. And now you have to press the OK button, adjust voltage. Now you can adjust the voltage setting for the motor being switched off because the record player has been turned off. You can there adjust this parameter. For example, if we decrease it, you can see that the voltage also drops. Turn motor on, press OK. Press OK button, adjust voltage. Now this is the same, but now for the motor being switched on. Again, you can increase or decrease the value. Now it has detected some thresholds that are used to detect the motor switching state, whether it's on or off. Turn motor off, press OK button. Stop platter. Press OK button. Turn motor on. Now it has detected the threshold that is used for the overload protection. And we're back in the main menu. So here you can actually, there's another function that can be better to calibrate the overload protection. I'm not going through this now. You can read about it in the manual. You can of course reset all settings, format the flash memory inside MagicQuartz. You can trigger the flash wear leveling, and then it comes to some settings where you can change numeric values. For example, you can set up the default hertz, which means the frequency setting for your turntable. In this case, it's an European unit that was made to operate at 50 hertz, so 50 hertz is okay. Here you can again manually set up the voltages for the motor being switched off or on. You can adjust the voltage drop characteristic, which means whenever you decrease the frequency, it automatically decreases the generated voltage. This parameter controls the current threshold above which the motor is supposed to be switched on when you turn on MagicQuartz. This is the overload protection threshold. Any current draw above this value will trigger an overload protection warning and switch off the power supply. This is the current setting above which the internal amplifier is supposed to be defective. For example, if it has developed a short circuit when there's no load supply to it. So this is something that is checked during startup of MagicQuartz. So this is set to 10. This setting controls the detection whether the motor is being switched on or off. This setting compensates for the inrush current when you switch the turntable on. I'm not going to details again. You can read about this in the manual. there's the option to apply a low pass filter to the optical signal. This is very useful if you have problems with ambient light flicker, which may disturb the optical signal, of course. There's the option to perform a faster calibration when you enter live quartz mode. This is something I have done here during this demo. And there are other parameters that allow you to change the behavior of the live quartz algorithm. For example, this max OK delta is the maximal delta value when entering live quartz, which is considered to be OK. So if you have the quick calibration turned off, it also makes sure that this delta value is acceptable. The buffer size controls the size of the speed buffer in MagicQuartz. So if you have a bigger setting for buffer size, you get more average speed readout values, and for lower values you get a more responsive speed display. You can also set when MagicQuartz automatically clears the buffer. This happens, for example, if you have too many bad measurements, you want to reset the buffer so that the speed readings are correct again. And this can be controlled with this setting. Quartz latency actually controls how little or how much the quartz algorithm kicks in when being in live quartz mode. Quartz range actually limits the frequency range that you're allowed to change the speed. For example, here it's set to 10%. This means for if you're running at 50 Hertz, the live quartz algorithm is only allowed to set values between 45 and 55 Hertz. Wait on start is a function that pauses the quartz algorithm when the turntable platter is spinning up. In this example, it's set to 3 rotations. You can also wait if there have been bad measurements. This is set to 1. You can set which delta values are considered to be present for bad measurements. So if there's a delta value that is too high, MagicQuartz can expose the behavior that has been set by the wait values. And of course you can configure a standby time in minutes. After this time, MagicQuartz automatically goes into a standby mode to save energy. The last two values allow you to change the time counter. This is necessary if you, for example, reset all parameters to default. It also resets the clock, and this can be used to restore your counters. So this is useful if you want to keep track of wear leveling, for example. So these are all functions in the setup menu. Normally you do not have to go through all these settings because most of the time MagicQuartz will also work with the default settings, but clearly you would have to set up default hertz so that the default frequency is matching your turntable, and you would have to go through the calibrate motor function. So these are all functions of MagicQuartz. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're interested in MagicQuartz, please have a quick look at my website if there are any updates. I really hope to release the final version very soon, and then you can build your own. It will be very affordable. It's really designed to be not expensive, but the real power of MagicQuartz is definitely in its software. So see you next time. Bye bye.